Hello students, in this session
let us solve a question on springs. If the wire diameter of a compressive helical spring is increased by 2%, the change in spring stiffness is what an amount it is increased or decreased, right? This we have to find out. So this is a question of basically springs, where we are given with a helical spring and its diameter is increased by 2%. We have to find out what is the change in stiffness in the spring. This we have to find out, right? So this was asked in GATE 2018. So let us solve this question.
This is the question of springs. There is a helical spring for which some data is given, and we know the deflection of the spring is given by this formula. We already know. You should remember this formula, it will be used in this question. We are given that the wire diameter which is given by small d is increased by 2%. Then what is the change in stiffness of this spring? What is the stiffness change in this spring, where capital D is the coil dia, number of active turns are n in this formula, W is the weight applied, it may be compressive or tensile load, right? And G is the modulus of rigidity, right? This is known to us, right? Now, if small d is increased and other things are constant, what is the change in stiffness of this spring? This we have to find out, right? So let us solve this question. Now, what is the stiffness? Basically, what is the stiffness of spring? That is the weight per unit deflection. So what is the deflection due to load applied? So load upon deflection is the stiffness. So if I put here W by this, in this formula, deflection formula, it is known to us, spring formula, that is 8 W d cube n upon g d to the power 4. This is the value of k. So it will come out to be W and W will cancel out. So it will come out to be g d to the power 4 divided by 8 capital D cube n. So basically this is stiffness, g d to the power 4 divided by 8 d cube n. So this is the stiffness of the spring, right? And other things are constant, then the spring stiffness is proportional to small d to the power 4, wire dia to the power 4, this is proportional to this, right? So initially the D1, the wire dia initially was given to us, and finally it is increased by 2%, that is D2 is 1.02 times D1. There is 2% increase in diameter, it is given to us, right? It is given to us that final dia is 2% in initial dia, this is known to us. D2 is 1.02 times D1, this was given to us, right? 2% increase in diameter. If D2 is 1.02 D1, then we can find out that K1 by K2 from this equation, K1 by K2 will be equal to D1 by D2. And from here, we know K2 can be found out, K2, which is the final stiffness, that is equal to K1 times D2 by D1. And D2 by D1 is 1.02. D1 by D2 power 4. Power 4 we have forgot. That is power 4 also. So this will be D2 by D1 to the power 4. Right. So K2 will be equal to, this is D2 by D1, that is 1.02. So 1.02 to the power 4 K1. Solve it, the power of 1.02 times to the power 4. So you will get K2 will be equal to, you will get 1.0824, multiplying it 4 times K1. So it means that stiffness increases by this amount, right? 1.0824 times K1. So this is 8.2%. If you convert it in percent, this is 8.2% of the initial stiffness, right? So increase in K is basically 8.24%. 8.24% of the initial that initial stiffness, right? This is the answer of this question.